There is circadian rhythms that you perform the best in, and it tends to be your local time, tends to be your afternoon. And so if you're traveling and you're changing time zones, this matters. But if you're also manipulating when you're performing, even within your time zone, it can mimic the same effect. So what I'm getting at here is if you can optimize timing, you can get the benefits of sleep extension and improving sleep quality without changing either of them. And what I mean by this is the research is so cool here because it comes directly from games one. There's a lot of research across a bunch of different sports, the NBA, the NFL, Major League Baseball, the NHL. There's a bunch of studies going back through 10 years, 30 years, up to 40 years of historical games. And they look at these things and they say, okay, can we predict who's going to win more games based simply on a combination of are they playing in their right circadian time or not? So the example here would be, let's imagine you have a West Coast team and they are normally used to competing at 4 p.m. on the West Coast. And they travel to the Midwest or the East Coast, but they compete at a time that is still 4 o'clock on the West Coast time. So it's their normal circadian rhythm. They have a big advantage over the other team because they're playing in their normal rhythm, despite the fact that they've changed time zones. So it's more complicated and more interesting than just, you know, jet lag, which is obviously very, very important. So this rhythm, there's a ton of information here. Stephen Lockley from Harvard, he's been around for forever, has published a ton in this area, was monumental in developing the circadian rhythm and light timing for the International Space Station. He has a great app. I have no affiliation to this, but it's called Time Shifter, which helps you set your supplementation and light and food stuff for if you're traveling internationally. I've used it for years. I've paid full price for it. Lots of stuff there, but he's done a ton of research on this stuff, and it's really compelling. So Steve has done so much cool work in this area, but I'm going to condense it to just hit a couple of points. One study I think of in particular was they went back and looked at performance in Olympic swimming from 2004 to 2016, and they were able to predict 0.3% of performance based simply on circadian timing. Right. So again, we're not talking about who slept more or who had sleep disorders or anything. It is simply, can you play and perform in the right time for your body? I think more interesting is Sherry Ma from Stanford, who I've mentioned before, spent, I think, about 3 years working with ESPN. And what she was able to do is predict somewhere between the neighborhood of 70 to 80% accuracy of who would win NFL games based simply on the team's time zone. So this is incredible. Obviously, this is stuff that people use in those in the sports betting world behind the scenes a lot, part of their information. If you ever wonder why a betting line is where it is on some teams, this is a huge component to that. It's certainly not the only one, but it's really cool stuff. So again, be able to understand and enhance your performance. If sleep extension is out of the question, if sleep diagnostic is out of the question, if sleep quality, you're trying and it's not working, whatever. Another way, again, you can get yourself to huge performance enhancements is manipulating your timing. The more you can stay consistent in performing in your own local space, whenever you're used to performing, the better you're going to be. Let me give you one tangible example so you have something to lock onto here. The University of Washington football team, my hometown team, candidly, is going to be dealing with the unique challenge. They are right now in the Pac-12, which means every team they play is on the West Coast. They're moving to a division that is in the Midwest. So they're going to be playing Ohio and Pennsylvania and Iowa and Minnesota and things like that. So let's imagine this. Let's imagine the University of Washington typically played their football games, as they do, either at 4:30 p.m. or 7:30 p.m. Washington time. Okay, great. So if they played a team at 4:30 at home, and that team came from the East Coast or Midwest, the University of Washington has an advantage. The other team traveled, and now they're competing at their normal local time. Huge win for the University of Washington. But another scenario gets more interesting. Let's imagine that they're on the road, and let's imagine they went to Ohio State as an example, and they played that game at 7:30 p.m. Eastern time zone. Now, this is actually still, despite the fact that they're on the road, this is still a huge advantage for the University of Washington because 7:30 East Coast time is still 4:30 West Coast time. So not only is the University of Washington competing on their normal circadian rhythm, but Ohio State in this case is competing at a way delayed rhythm. Typically, those teams are going to be playing at about noon local time. So instead of playing at noon local time, they're now playing at 7:30 local time. They've shifted their performance window 7.5 hours. So in this particular case, despite the fact we would be on the road, we'd have a 3-hour time zone difference, there would still be a slight 1-2% advantage for the University of Washington. Third example here would be the opposite. Let's imagine, again, University of Washington typically plays at 4:30 p.m. Seattle time, and they go to Columbus or Ohio State, and they play a game at Columbus or Ohio's normal time, which is noon Eastern time, right? This is now 9 o'clock in the morning for the University of Washington. This is now almost 8 hours earlier than normal. It would be a massive advantage, not only because of the time shift change, the travel, being on the road, but because of circadian rhythms. You would probably be looking at, you know, maybe a 4-5-6% advantage just on that fact alone to the Ohio State team. So something to really pay attention to. Those of you that have the opportunity or ability to manipulate this, I would encourage you to do so. But something, again, we can really pay attention to when sleep extension or sleep quality are not on the table as variables that we can improve. If you enjoyed this clip, you can watch the full episode by clicking here.